Hello, everybody, and welcome to Test Prep 22. My name is Steve Ford, and welcome to another How to Pass a TOEFL Speaking Section video. Above all else, the speaking section is about feeling comfortable, and my aim is to pass on some tips to you so that you can be ready for the day of your test. Today, I will be going over an independent speaking question. Remember that independent speaking questions are basically divided into two types: proving or disproving one side of an argument, or talking about a personal experience. Let's listen to the question, the student's answer, and afterward I will make some comments and suggestions. Here's the question. What place or landmark in your country do you recommend other people visit? Explain why you think other people should go there. Include details and examples to support your explanation. Okay, let's look at our student's intro.
I live in Moscow, you know, it's capital of Russia, and they have lots of sightseeing and lots of foreigners who like to, you know, look at these things.
So, there have lots of sight things should be changed to there are lots of tourist attractions. The next part, and lots of friends who like to look at things, could be, and lots of tourists who like to check them out. That's a good phrasal verb right there, check out. You really want to focus on phrasal verbs to make sure that you can boost your score.
First of all, I like Kremlin. You know, Kremlin is a sort of castle built in the center of Moscow. It's like a hub. You know, in Kremlin, you can easily get by subway. You have some stations right beneath the main square, and you can know the Red Square.
So our student's first point covers the Kremlin as a tourist attraction, and he says, first of all, I like Kremlin. You know, Kremlin is sort of castle built in the center of Moscow. I like how he has introduced his first point. First of all, that will help you to stay focused. We can add in the Kremlin whenever that's mentioned. The odd mistake with articles and prepositions is okay, but if it's a constant, it can drive your score down. Next, it's like a hub. Good simile and good word choice. He can give himself a pat on the back for that one. You can easy get by subway. That's pretty close. You could say you can easily get there by subway. The next part is good. You have some stations right beneath the main square. Right beneath. Couldn't have said it better myself. Sounds like a native speaker. And you can know the Red Square. No is not the right word choice when we are visiting a place. I know it's used in other languages, but we need to change this to, and you can visit Red Square.
People who come to Moscow like to have some trips, take some breathtaking pictures in front of the main Moscow store called GUM. And, you know, there are a lot of churches. You can see some history. You can perceive the history of Moscow and of Russia by having a trip to the Kremlin.
Second point, people who come to Moscow like to have some trips. Here, I would change have some trips to go sightseeing. Breathtaking pictures. Breathtaking is an awesome word choice, but watch out for the pronunciation. Breath, noun, and breathe, verb, in this case, breathtaking. The main store our student is referring to is a huge department store in downtown Moscow and many other Russian cities called GUM. If you're going to make a local reference like that, you want to make sure that you really spell it out for your raider. Third point, you know there are a lot of churches. You can see some history, you can perceive history of Moscow and Russia by having a trip to the Kremlin. So he talks about the many churches of Moscow and perceive history. I'm going to change that to get to know the history of Moscow and Russia.
One last thing I'd like to add in is having a trip to the Kremlin is the wrong word choice, and you should say taking a trip to the Kremlin.
After the student's introduction, which was a little confusing, I found his answer to be cohesive with three separate examples, that's great, giving some description to back them up. The student's word choice at times was unclear, but nothing major. There was a pretty good pace in his speaking, no long pauses, and there were no real issues regarding pronunciation. I liked how the student was able to compare some of the tourist attractions to something in his imagination. I really like that. The Kremlin is sort of like a castle, and it's like a hub. This shows that the student has the ability to quickly think in an abstract way in English. Not an easy task, considering he only had 45 seconds to do it. By the way, this student already got the score he needed, as he did considerable practice from the time of this recording. If you can pay attention to word choice, it will definitely boost your score. Well, everybody, we'll keep this short and sweet, and I look forward to our next test prep video. Bye for now.